What do you suggest?
Arguably one of the most recognizable songs in American pop culture, The Lion Sleeps Tonight, has been featured in more than 15 films and musicals, covered by more than 150 artists, translated into French, Japanese, Spanish, Dutch, and many other languages, has reached number one on the charts all over the world, and has earned, some estimated, over $15 million in composer royalties. Possessing such a unique sound, with its doo-wop beat and wide range of vocals, one might ask themselves, where and from whom did such an enchanting song come from? That's an easy one. Jay Siegel and the Tokens in 1961. Then it's definitely Pete Seeger and the Weavers in 1951. Not exactly. We're gonna go back to the early 1900s in the Zulu heartland of South Africa to find out where exactly the lion sleeps tonight. It all began back in 1909 in what is present-day Swaziland, when a man by the name of Solomon Linda was born. Linda grew up in the Masinga in rural Zululand as a typical kid of the time. He herded cattle, and although he couldn't read or write, he had a connection to music and was strongly influenced by the new syncopated music that had swept across South Africa. In his 20s, he moved to Johannesburg, where he led an a cappella band that entertained local beer halls. It was in 1939 when a talent scout at Gallows Records invited Linda's group, the Original Evening Birds, to record an album. Here is where they would come to produce their most famous hit, Mbube, which is Zulu for lion. The song was inspired by an experience Linda had herding cattle, which a lion wouldn't leave his presence. The lyrics were so simple, but its call and response chants and harmonies were so mesmerizing that the song came to define a whole generation of Zulu a cappella singing, a style that became known simply as Mbube. Many music scholars say that the hit song was the first African record to sell 100,000 copies. And although record sales flourished, it wasn't until 1951 that it was released to the masses in the film Cry the Beloved Country.
You must stand in line for this. Have you your money for the ticket?
Over and over.
It was in the same year that the song took flight, when folk singer Pete Seeger released his song after discovering Linda's record that was destined for the trash. He really liked the sound, so he made it into a folk song, but misinterpreted the pronunciation of Mbube, giving us Wimowe. Following Seeger, a few different versions of the song were released, including a pop rendition by Carl Denver and another folk tune by the Kingston Trio. It was in 1961 when American songwriter George Weiss came up with six words that fit Linda's original improvised melody. He collaborated with Jay Siegel and the Tokens to give us the famous American tune, "The Lion Sleeps Tonight." Those six words were,
"In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight."
While "The Lion Sleeps Tonight" was receiving great success, Solomon Linda received none of it. Instead, he lived in Soweto as a poor man before dying at the age of 53 in 1962, with today's equivalent of $22 to his name. In the 1990s, the South African group Ladysmith Black Mambazo helped the song regain popularity as it was used in the Disney film and eventually the Broadway musical The Lion King. Still, the Linda family was living in poverty. It wasn't until May 25th, 2000, when South African writer Ryan Milan wrote an article in Rolling Stones magazine that this injustice has been brought to the masses. With the help generated by the article, Solomon Linda's family took Disney to court in a well-publicized copyright case in 2004. Although the publishers of Seeger's Wemoway weren't named in the lawsuit, they admit they did not pay Linda in any royalties and promised to compensate the Linda family annually. In 2006, a settlement was agreed upon. It implicitly acknowledges that "The Lion Sleeps Tonight" is of South African origin and rooted in South African culture. The undisclosed settlement also means Solomon Linda's daughters will finally be able to escape the extreme poverty they know too well. Before his death, Solomon Linda was asked by his daughter if he was bitter that his song brought success to others. Instead, he was happy for it brought them joy.
Oh, Nancy, 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 o